FUD-Busters are back, and this time we're addressing a major elephant in the room. Today we're taking on a biggie, a real hot potato, the age-old, hotly contested energy consumption debate. Let's make something clear from the start. The Bitcoin network uses a lot of electricity. This isn't really in dispute. Bitcoin is created through a process known as mining. This is done using a consensus mechanism known as proof of work. Proof of work basically involves using brute computer power to solve complex mathematical problems to verify transactions on the blockchain.
Feel the power.
Oh, I can feel it.
This used to be done on home computers, but it now requires specialist equipment that can handle the intense processing power. Brute computing power, special equipment. Sounds like these involve a lot of electricity. Correct, they very much do. So what do we mean when we say this is FUD? Well, a large part of it lies in how it compares to other related fields. Let's start with its carbon footprint relative to banks. According to recent research done by Yassine Alamandra, an analyst at ARK Invest, Bitcoin is actually much more efficient than traditional banking and gold mining on a global scale. Alamandra found that traditional banking consumes 2.34 billion gigajoules per year and gold mining 500 million gigajoules. Bitcoin, on the other hand, consumes 184 million gigajoules, less than 10% and 40% of traditional banking and gold mining, respectively. If you compare it to Visa, a single transaction of Bitcoin has the same carbon footprint as 680,000 Visa transactions. But this isn't comparing like for like. They're fundamentally different systems. Bitcoin is a complete self-contained monetary settlement system, while Visa transactions are non-final credit transactions that rely on external underlying settlement rails. The other important thing to look at is where the electricity Bitcoin uses comes from. A recent study by the Cambridge Centre for Alternative Finance found that 39% of Bitcoin's energy outlay derives from renewables, with 76% of miners using renewables in some capacity. Miners' main motivation is profit. This means that they will usually look for the cheapest sources of electricity, which increasingly leads them to use electricity from renewable sources. The bulk of Bitcoin mining operations happens in places like China, Sweden, and Iceland, to name a few. Most of the areas are rich in renewable, low-cost energy sources. Another argument in favor of Bitcoin's energy use is that of transparency. CoinShares Chief of Strategy, Melton Demirez, raised an interesting counter-argument, suggesting that mining Bitcoin is a good use of energy. She notes that Bitcoin is incredibly transparent in its energy use, while other industries are much more opaque. This means it's going to be far easier to solve the problem, although it also means it's far easier to use its energy usage as a weapon. Again, it's important to remember that any new technology that threatens to disrupt billion-dollar for-profit industries will face a lot of criticism.
Greed, for lack of a better word.
It's easy to dish out alarming statistics to further an agenda, but it's important to do your own research and uncover the hidden truths in any argument. Or you could just watch an episode of FUD-Busters and let us do some of the heavy lifting for you. So guys, what do you want to see FUD-Busters tackle next? Leave us a note in the comments below. And don't forget, like, subscribe, follow, and as always, hashtag to the moon.